Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to model a simple engine in SOLIDWORKS. Here we are going to create each and every part separately and we will assemble at the end, and we will make simple animation for this. So I hope you like it. So let's start to create this beautiful engine in SOLIDWORKS. Now let's open file, new part. Okay. Now we are in the interface, SOLIDWORKS interface, and here we are going to create our first part of engine, piston head. So we will choose first plane, go to sketch and choose your front plane line, and I'll start from here, then go back to the point and it will automatically convert into arc, but we want opposite arc. Even though we have other option, choose 3-point arc. Okay, now let me define some relations. Horizontal, and these two points vertical. That's it. Now let's define 25 millimeter, (62.5 millimeter). Okay, keep this one lower. (54.5 millimeter). Now let me select the circle, radius 40 millimeter. Okay, now let's make the ring shape for. Now let me start from here. Now select these two lines, collinear, smart dimension. Let's define the distance 5 millimeter, 2.5 millimeter, the same here, 2.5 millimeter, and the distance between these two lines 3 millimeter. Now this inside things we need to trim. So here we will choose one option, trim entities, click power trim and simply just drag your mouse and it will trimmed. See? Okay. Now let me choose your offset, keep 2 millimeter, and I'll choose this one, reverse. I like to use reverse, and here select cap line so that both the end will going to close. Okay, now see, this is a straight line, so it's useful for us, nothing different. Now here you will see this is tapered, so simply delete this line, draw a line, vertical line. Now we want to coincide, so go to trim entities, select here corner and select these two lines, and it will automatically met here. Okay, now this is vertical. Now go to feature and choose revolve boss base command, and I'll choose axis of revolution, this vertical line. See how it's going to revolve and make a solid body. Keep end condition 360 degree. Okay, we change appearance from here, brushed nickel. Now let me choose front plane, a sketch, normal. Now here we want to cut two things, one is circle, and let me keep the diameter is 12.5 millimeter, and I'll choose here 3-point arc. We will cut this both together. Now select 1, 2 and 3. This all center points, vertical so that it will comes in one line. Smart dimension. Select this one, hold shift key and select this upper corner. Or if not, then simply we will choose center point and connect up to here. mm and this center to center distance 38 mm. Okay, now select this one, hold shift key, this center point already. Now distance from here to hold shift key 10 mm. Now see, this is fully defined. Even we need to close because there are two bodies. Now let me choose here extruded cut in features command. Keep here end condition through all both so that it will moves and cut in both side. Now see, front plane. Now here again we want to create a circle. This is center point and 14.5 mm. And another circle 12.5 mm, just equivalent to the previous one. And here isometric view. Now we want to play up to this wall, so extrude. We will choose offset 12 mm. See, it's come here to 12 mm from center point. And here we will choose up to surface. We will select outer surface reverse so that it will moves this side. Okay, now let's see inside a portion is created. This is support for the piston pin. Now the same thing we will mirror, so choose front plane, mirror, and here select this option extrude cut one, drop down and choose extruded boss 1. Okay, now let's see. So this is the our simple piston. Let me save this one. Piston, new folder, engine. And the first part piston, save. Now let's make the next part new. Okay, now in the next part we will make piston pin. So simply choose front plane, a sketch, circle, and let me draw a circle 12.5 mm. And select extruded boss base. And this length we will go for 45 mm. But here end condition we will keep mid plane. And one more thing, we will make it hollow. So choose thin feature. And here thickness defined 2.5 mm. Reverse, so that it will moves inside. Okay, .5 chamfer. I'll select the top face. polished nickel safe. Piston pin. Now let's try other parts. Now here we will make the third part connecting rod. So sketch, and again we will choose here front plane, and let me draw two circles. Smart dimension, let's define this 120 millimeter, 42 millimeter, inside circle 32 millimeter. Millimeter, and the inside one 12.5 millimeter. Okay, now let me choose one, select both the lines, a center point vertical, or better to defined by center line, because we need the center lines. Now let me draw a line from here to connect here, 3-point arc, select this point tangent. Okay, now again this point also, this point and circle, tangent, that's it. Let me choose mirror entities, arc and line, vertical line. Let's define this. Eight millimeter, okay, and vertical length also we will define 35 millimeter. Now see, drawing is fully defined, no need to define anything more. And again choose the line, and we need to define some vertical select these three lines symmetric. Millimeter, five millimeter. So this is also sort out. Now let's come down line, connect, and again choose the line and connect from here to this point, make sure it is vertical. Now select again these three lines and symmetric relation. Okay, millimeter length, and select this vertical length 12 millimeter. Okay, that's fine. Now everything is fully defined, just go to feature and choose extruded boss revolve. Here we need to define which body we want to extrude, because there are many closed bodies. So we will select this. Oh, it's going to choose half circle because of construction line. So these things we are going to extrude first. Keep end condition mid plane 20. See, it's going to move in both direction. Okay, Now again we will use the same sketch. Click on sketch, extruded boss base, and this time we will select this inside face. Keep end condition mid plane 12 mm, and also let me choose this vertically created parts, and here we selected mid plane and 12 mm thickness. Okay, that's it. Now here we will make one cutout. So what plane we like to choose? Right plane, sketch, normal, and let me choose here a straight slot. Okay, now select origin point and the center point and create relation vertical. Okay, that's important relation. We need to define the distance from center. Okay, let's define this first. 62 mm, radius 4 mm. Center line. Now it's easy to define the distance. Enter. See. Now it's time to cut. We want to make extrude cut. Take it reverse direction. And here we will choose offset. We don't want to extrude from center. 6 mm offset. You will see it comes ahead 6 mm. End condition you can keep through all. Not big deal. Now see. Even the same option we can do it for reverse side, or you can mirror it. So let's use same sketch, extrude cut. Offset 6 mm. Through all. Reverse. See, it's going this side. See. So this is your simple connecting rod. Let me choose material. Okay, we will define polished bronze so that it looks like a shiny metal. Let me save. Connecting rod. Enter. Now let's make the next part, crankshaft. Here the next part is crankshaft. We will start with front sketch, and here we will choose right plane. Let's draw here two circles. Smart dimension, and outer one we will keep 38 mm, and the inner one 34 mm. That's it. Now choose extruded boss base. Now here go to selected contour and choose only inner one. We want to extrude only inner one. Reverse side. And here the length 25 mm. Okay. Again we will use the same sketch, extrude. In selected contour choose outer ring so that we will extrude solid body. 8 mm in forward direction. See blind condition and 8 mm. Let me choose the material so that it looks titanium, brushed titanium. Okay, now let me choose this face, sketch, normal. Now here we will make one. Let me choose here 3-point arc. Now first we will make relation, these two points horizontal. Now here also let me choose this two point, hold shift key and select both point horizontal. Okay, again choose 3-point arc. Now collect these two points. Okay, it's time to define. This is the center point for this up. Hold shift key, merge. So this lower circle point is merge. Now I'll choose these two points vertical, that's it, and define a gap. Mm. This gap let me keep 88 mm, and here the radius 46 mm. I'll choose upper radius. Mm. And this radius 90 mm. Okay. Now let me choose this point tangent. See, the drawing is fully defined. I hope you note down all the dimensions carefully. Isometric view, extrude. And we will extrude up to 15 mm. Keep end condition 15 mm. Okay. That's it. A sketch, circle. Now just keep your cursor here. You will find a center point here, or you can simply choose. And keep this 32 mm, enter, extrude. If now this length we will make 15 mm, that's it. Now these two parts we will mirror, so choose mirror, and here select face and features to mirror. So I'll choose 1, 2. Okay. Click geometry pattern. See. Now let me choose this face. Sketch. Now at the center we will make one flange. 34 mm, enter. And extrude this body 5 mm. See. Okay. Now in this face again we want to make the same flange but in reverse direction. So sketch, choose this face and select our first second sketch, no, not second sketch, third extrude bar. See, just click this one, convert entity. See, it is converted here, you will see. Now we will rotate this. Rotate entities, entities to rotate. So select all the geometry, uncheck this box, otherwise it will not rotate. Center of rotation, select this point, and here degree of rotation 180 degree. Click, see, is going to rotate. Okay, fully defined sketch, calculate. Okay, So no need to define anything. Simply we just use convert entity command, convert it and rotate it, extrude. And this one we will extrude 15 millimeter as usual. Okay, sketch normal, and bottom we will make one circle, and the diameter is 32 millimeter. Distance, let me choose 25 millimeter. Now we will create hold center point, shift key, and the origin point vertical. Take the isometric view. Now let's extrude this face, extruded boss base, and this one we will extrude up to 30 millimeter. See, okay. This face is sketch. Now again I'll choose the first sketch number 3, convert entity. Now you see it is converted. Do one thing, undo. We want to use this body. Okay, so click the extruded body 6, convert entity. Now see, we converted this body lines, extrude 15 millimeter. Now this time choose this face, sketch, and at this center point draw one circle, and that is 34 millimeter. Enter. Extrude 2.5 millimeter. Okay, now we will mirror whole body so that we will complete our crankshaft. Mirror here, select this face, clear, go to bodies to mirror, select whole body. You will see preview here. Look, so this is the our crankshaft. Save. Crankshaft. Enter. Let's see other part. Next part here is engine upper block, top plane is sketch. Let me choose corner rectangle, and I'll start from, okay, let me start from this corner. Fillet 10 millimeter, and I'll choose both the edges. Okay, smart dimension 271 millimeter. Let me draw vertical line. It helps for circle. Let's draw a circle. Trim entity. Choose here power trim. Trim this half circle and this face. Millimeter. Okay. 13 millimeter. even though the same circle we can make here. Trim entity, trim this one. This gap should be 15 millimeter. That's fine. Mirror entities, let me choose these two things and mirror about this line, center line. Okay, now let me choose trim entity, power trim. That's it. See, this drawing is fully defined. So simply go to feature and choose extruded boss base. Now here 110 millimeter the length. See, okay, again we will use top plane sketch and let me choose offset 4 millimeter and let me select this bottom line. Or before going to select, do one thing. Select this whole bottom face, convert entities. And in convert entity, delete these things which we don't need. You will see now choose offset entities 4 millimeter and let me choose here, select chain and cap, choose line so that it will close from this end. See, okay. Now let me see the full round created extruded boss base. We want to extrude only 3 millimeter. See, it's going in upward side. Raw material, we will use sandblasted steel so that it looks real engine block. Linear pattern, direction I'll choose this one, seven millimeter, 15 number of patterns. And features, let me choose this one, it's going downward direction, so simply reversed. You will see 15 number of fins are okay. Oh, look, the cool engine fins are created. That's it. Save. Upper block. Now let's make the last part, lower block of engine. Let's make the last part of engine, lower block. Front plane, a sketch. Let me draw here 2 circles. Connect a line. Outer one 50 millimeter and inner one 34 millimeter. Now let me choose here trim entities, choose power trim, just drag your mouse and see it's trimmed. Okay, go to feature and choose extruded boss base, and this direction we will extrude 20 millimeter, and in direction 2 also we will extrude up to 5 millimeter, because here we are going to create a ball. Okay, again we will choose front plane, a sketch. Now choose outer line, convert entities, then choose here line, then again we will try one line here. Three-point arc. Now select the center point of this arc, hold shift key and origin point, merge. That's it. Now let's define. (52 millimeter) and the upper one 65 millimeter. And the radius, it's 145/2, 72.5 millimeter. See, the drawing is fully defined. Extrude 5 millimeter, but make it reverse. See, okay. Now we want to mirror this body, so first we will create a plane. Drop down the menu of geometry reference geometry. First plane we will choose front plane, then distance 140.5 millimeter, but it's going opposite side, so click flip offset. See, okay. Now with the help of this plane we will mirror this whole body, so mirror, and here you can choose the plane and bodies. You can directly choose bodies to mirror, or even you can select feature mirror also, but body option is better for us. Okay, that's it. Now this face is sketch normal. Now let me choose outer line, hold shift key, and this convert entities, offset 5 millimeter, and select this line. Now you will see the preview. Keep cap also line closed. See, okay, we created here a closed geometry. Now you will understood from here. Extrude and here choose up to surface, and we will choose opposite surface. Now you will see it's going to connect. Let me hide plane. So this is our lower block of engine. Let's define some material. Okay, brass, cast brass, save. Lower block. Now let's start to assemble the engine, and we will give little animation over there. Now here we are going to start assembly. Click file, new assembly. Okay, now here go to browse, and here we will choose upper and lower block. So select both the open upper lower. So right click float and make this one fixed. Rotate component, it's like this. Okay, choose your mat, select these two faces, coincident relation, select this face and bottom. Okay, now you will see here now we will choose advanced mat width. I'll select these two faces here. These two faces. Okay. So that it fits in the center of the body. Insert component, browse, and this time we will enter crankshaft. Rotate component, mat, select this circular face and this face, concentric, drag, this face and this face coincide. Okay, the length seems perfect. Now let me insert component, browse, parts, piston, piston pin, connecting rod. Mat, let me choose piston and hole of piston, piston pin and hole of piston pin. Okay. Advanced mat width, go to inside, select the faces of piston, then here two faces of pin, these two faces, so that it will comes in the center position. Look. Okay, if you like to change length, you can simply click open, edit feature, and here 44, I think we selected 49 also, we can keep. Okay, cancel it, save, save in assembly. Now see, now let me choose mat, select inside piston pin, connecting rod coincident, advanced mat width, let me choose these two faces. Now this two faces of connecting rod. Now you will see how it's going to fix inside pin. Okay. Now just go to standard mat, select the whole of this and crankshaft concentric relation. Okay, piston and whole of this block concentric relation. Okay, now let me try, cancel it. Now that's perfectly, it's rotating. Now here we will copy this to here, copy with mat command. Here select component 1, piston, piston pin and connecting rod. Here select next, and here we need to choose these two things. First we will select this and this, see, concentric, concentric, two things we created because these two are related and same entities. Okay, now see, but these are different, so we need to select this three. Hold shift key, piston, mat, concentric relation. Same thing we will repeat here. Okay, again we will choose the same width option. Now these two faces of connecting rod. Okay, now go to standard mat concentric relation, pin and select the whole of the piston connecting rod. Okay, now this one is created. Let me choose this hole and this piston crankshaft. Now block hole and piston concentric relation. Okay, now let me see how is going up and down. Copy with mats, piston, piston pin, connecting rod, next, crankshaft and upper block. Oh, that's it. See, we change the direction by just press left forward backward key. Okay, cancel. Now all the relations are created here. So this is the our assembly created. Even though let me choose perspective view is not perfect, so let's keep the same If you choose isometric view, trimetric, diametric, even though we can hide this view header from here, save, rebuild and save the documents. Final assembly. Now let me choose here Motion Manager. Go to Motion Study, and this is simple animation. We don't need to keep anything else. Just drag your assembly up to 10 seconds. Even I like to change frame rate, 50 is better. And here you can choose motor. Keep rotary component. Let me choose this face. Make it lit reversed. RPM 20 revolution per minute. Okay, now click here calculate. Now once you click calculate, it will calculate the movement for this and it will take few seconds, and once it is finished then we will play. Even though we can edit this RPM speed also, now you can directly play. Now see, this is okay to understand the movement. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.